First, log into your Gmail account. Now you will be in your screen, account, Gmail account screen. Now, to the right of the corner, right top corner, you have this 9 dots. Press that and scroll down. You will be having this classroom. Select that. Now, yes, it has opened. Now, what you have to do is, this already I have created. Now you have to create your own classroom. So let me see, let us see how to create a classroom. Now here there is a plus symbol. So plus there, press there. Now it has two options, join class and create class. Now you are going to create a new class. So I just press this create class and check this box and continue. Now we can give you a class name. Let me give mathematics. Class. Section, if you have section, say for example, A section, B section, that you can give here, or else I just leave it as there is only one section. Subject, suppose I am going to create this class, integral calculus. Or, yes, let us keep this. Calculus, and then whichever room number you have for that respective class, you can give that room number or no need. But in all these things, only the class name is mandatory. All the section, subject, room, either you can give the details or no need to give. So press create. Now it's creating the classroom. If you already have the classroom for your class, then you can directly go to the classroom and create the forms. Now we are inside that newly created mathematics class, and this is the code through which your students will join your classroom. Now we are going to create a quiz assignment. Now for that, in order to do that, go to the select the classwork and press create. In create, there are options available. One is assignment, quiz assignment, question, material, etc. Assignment is if you want to give your students some assignment questions, and if you already have it in your Word file, then you can directly go into that, attach the file from your local drive, or else you can directly type the assignment in this. And question, likewise, you can give questions to your students. And material, you can, if you have your teaching materials or lecture notes, that you can upload it in this particular link. Now we are going to create a quiz, which is a multiple choice questions. So we just press quiz assignment. You can give title or you can just leave. Now I am going to create a blank quiz. Here also again the same. Here it will have these options, documents, slides, sheets, drawings, forms. But we are going to create a quiz. So I just press the blank quiz. You can give a name for this blank quiz. You select it and give a name. For example, I'm going to create this quiz for integral calculus and let it be for the chapter 1 or unit 1 like that. So let me give it as chapter 1. Here also you rename this. If you give the name for that, it will be better so that later you can recognize, or else it will give it as a blank quiz only. That is why we give the name. And if you want to give some description for this form, for example, it is dealt with some concepts in that chapter 1. If this question, all the questions which you are going to create based on some concepts in this chapter 1, then you can give an explanation here, some description here. Now, we are going to create forms. But before that, we have to keep ready the questions. So here, what we are going to do in this is creating of quizzes, multiple choice questions for mathematics. So normally many equations are there, even the answers also will be equations. So in which case, how to do that? Because in this quiz, you can plain text it will accept. But if when it comes to the equation, it is not possible for you to type it here. So what you have to do is, you have to create JPEG files of the equations. So how to do that? We'll see that. So let me minimize this. Already I have the questions in a Word file. So here already I have created the questions and its options. So now what we are going to do is, we are going to copy and paste it. But we'll see whether if we copy and paste it, will it work? So first, let me copy it. Control C. And then now I am pasting it here. See, when I paste it, the equation, this portion is not coming. So what we have to do? How to deal with this? I cannot directly type the equation here. Equation editor is not there. So in which case, what we have to do? We delete this and we'll see how to do that. So first, what you have to do is, you have to create JPEG file of each and every equation. So for example, let us consider this as one equation. I have to create a JPEG of this. And the options, each options, I have to create separate JPEG, and I have to store it in a folder. So first, let me create a folder for that. Here, this is my local drive. In this, I'm going to create a new folder. Maths, let me give the name Maths first. Okay. Now, whatever questions I'm going to convert it as a JPEG, that I'm going to store it in this particular folder. Right. Now, how to create JPEG in this? So a simple tool is snipping tool. So go to the search box and then type SNIP. You will be having this snipping tool appearing on this. So click that. Now I just click new. So when I create new, the word file becomes blurred. Now it is ready for catching the image. So now I keep my mouse here and copy that. See, that particular portion alone I am able to extract. Now save it. Where I have to save it? Already I have created in my C drive, I have created a Maths Quiz folder. So select that Maths Quiz folder. Yes. And then give a name. Default, it will give it as Capture JPG, but I don't want to keep the name. So since this is the first question, let me give relevant as question 1 dot JPG. Now this will be saved. Now I want to, this is the question. So for question, I give Q1, Q2 and all. For options, I will give Q1A, Q1B and all. So as a easy recognition. So now I am creating new. Now I select the second question. Yes, now it has been selected. Now I save it. Save it as Q1. Since it is the first option, so I give Q1_A and save. Now again, I select the option B. Now I give the file name as Q1B. So better you give the name for the JPEG files in a meaningful way. This is question 1 and it's option A, option B. If it has 3 options, 4 options, then you give Q1_C, Q1_D and all. Now, I have created the first question. Now, I want to create second question also. So, what? How many questions you have, that much file you create and store it in that folder. Now, again, let me see for Q2. Yes. Now, so I am doing it as Q2. Yes. And then again you, this is option A. Save as Q2_A. The first option, and again press the new. Now copy it. Yes, and Q2_D. So if you open that folder, yes, just now you have stored all you can see all these equations stored here. Now I minimize this. Now open this form. Now we are going to add the two questions and its choices here. So how we are going to add? Here already option one is there. Since my question consists of only two choices, so I keep your cursor here near option one and then press enter. Now option two is also created. Now in untitled question, where we are going to paste our question. So how to do that? Select this image icon. So press it. Now it will open this window where it will have many options. We are going to upload it from our system. So and it is the default. So I go with that. Press this browse. And then question one. I select the question one. Open. Now the question is uploaded. See here, the question has come. Now, already by default, it is multi-choice, but other type of questions also there. It is short answer. This will you can give the questions where the user, the students can write in one or two words, which can be for the 2 marks and all. And for paragraph, you can give a questions where the user, the student is expected to write for 5 marks or more than that. And check multiple choice when the user has to select only one answer among the given 4 or 5 choices. Then checkbox when more than one answer suits for the particular question, then you can go for checkbox and so on. Now, anyway, this question is multiple choice. So I am selecting this multiple choice. So for the option also, I have to paste the image. So here, press this image icon. Now the screen again comes, browse. Select the question. Already we have said this is for option A of Q1 and this option B of Q1. Now I select this first option. Yes. Now see here it has come. Now for option 2, I'm selecting the again from the folder. Now, for this, I have to give the correct answer also. That will not be visible to the students. But if they press the correct answer, if they choose the correct answer, it has to allocate the marks. So for that, what we have to do? And we have to make this required field to on. Because if you don't give this required to be on, then there is no need for the student to answer the question. They can skip the questions. But our aim is not that. So what we are doing is we make this as mandatory so that the students cannot skip this question. Even if they skip this question, it will not allow them to submit the question paper. So we make this as a mandatory field. That is required. They have to answer, and then you press the answer key. Now you have to give the correct answer for that. Now I have stored that answer at the end of this Word file. So let me go down. So what is the first answer? Correct answer is B. So this is the correct. So I select this. Now see here, a tick mark has come. Now this is the correct answer we have given in the form. And I want to know if the students select this, how correct answer, how much marks I have to allocate them. I can give one mark. Even more than that also, for one particular question, we can give. Anyway, time being, we'll give only one mark. Now I just press done. Yes. The first question is added to the form. Now I'm going to add the second question. So press this plus button. Now it is ready. The form is ready. Now you can add another question. Again, it is selected in multiple choice, so no problem. See that whether you have selected this multiple. If it is not there, then you have to select the multiple choice option. So now I press this add image icon, then browse. Then here the second question, Q2 JPG. Yes, it's uploaded. Now, as usual, again, you keep your icon, your cursor there in option one and press enter. Now it has created the option two also. If I have to create option three, again, you have to press it as, you have to press near the option two so that option three will be created. But now I don't want this option three because my question has only two choices. So I just delete it by pressing this cross mark. Okay, now for this, I want to add the choice. So again, the same way, add image, and select it, Q2A, okay. Now it is uploaded. Now for option two also, the same way. Yes, now I make it as a mandatory question, and then we have to add the answer key. The answer for the second question is A. So now I select this A to be the correct answer, and I want to give marks, not allocate marks. So one, if the answer is, if a student select the correct answer, they will be awarded one mark. Done. Okay, now the question is ready. I have created two more. Likewise, you can create how many number of questions you want. You can create as well as you can increase options. Say, for example, one question has only two choice, another question has four choice. You can add it by increasing the options. Even one question, you can make it as a multiple choice, another question as a short answer. Like that also you can do. Now, after creating this form, I have to create a link for that, or I have to send it to the mail IDs of my students. How to do that? So press send button, which is present in the right hand corner. Now it will open up this window. Here, if you press this, then you can send the mails, different mail IDs of the students. But I don't want this, because each time I have to type the mail IDs. I have to select it from my Gmail. All those things are there. But already class were in my class, already students must have been added. Once you create a class, Google Classroom, you have to add students into your Google Classroom. So I can just give a link to them so that all can access that link. So here, go here. This is a link and this is an embedded HTML. Now, I press this, a link is created, but this link seems to be a very big link. So instead, I want a shortened. Yes, shortened URL. It's a small URL. Now I press copy so that link will be copied. Now go back. go back to the previous, that is classwork. See here it is, you can press it. Now you will be in your classwork. And now I want to give this particular link to all my students. So how to do that? You can do that once you have added your students. Now I am the only teacher is there, but there is no students. Let me add only one student and I'll show you how to add other students also. And you can send the, once you create a link and post it for all the students, it will go. So here I have to create the students. Oh, I am adding it. So you can add like this. Other students also you can add like this. Now I just give invite. So the classroom joining will go to there, the respective student, in which they can press the join. Through that pressing of join, they can join this classroom. Afterwards, they can access this. Now, how to send that link? That is what we are going to see. Only one student I have added. Now we go to the stream and here I can paste them. Do this, I give some message. Access. And then I'm pasting. Already the link is, I have copied that link there. So now I press Ctrl V. And then I post. You press the post. Now the link of that quiz is posted. Now as soon as I post this, and the students joined in this classroom, they keep on whatever I post in this. They can see this and they can attend the quiz.